Welcome at Globron 123 Wi-Fi Security Issues. In particular, we look into the WPA2 PSK, Preset Key, CCMP, AIS, Advanced Encryption Standard Issues. And it actually relates to the vulnerability mentioned last week about WPA2 crack. Now, if you know the password, you actually can also see all the content. Then everything can be decrypted. And that's what we visualize over here. So we're going to capture WPA2 PSK frames, and we see the content within 5 minutes. Now, as you know, we have a white cap approach, so we're not a black hat, and awareness is important, and we also need to find solutions for customers using those protocols and the Wi-Fi network. So again, once you know the password, all the traffic can be seen. So we do a quick demo, and what do you need to do? So my name is Ronald van Kleunen. I'm running a security company, Wi-Fi company in Singapore. I have some security certifications, and we'll come back to that later because we're running also Wi-Fi security training. If you want to know more, you go to the links over here where you see some other publications which are security related, Wi-Fi related, and so on. Now, once the password is known, all the traffic can be decrypted. Now, how do you get actually that password? Now, you can actually just ask for it. If you go to someone's friend's home, you just ask, what is the Wi-Fi password to get access? Similar in cafeterias, hotels, public Wi-Fi hotspot, it's not too difficult to get a password. Maybe you have people walking around with a t-shirt now asking for the Wi-Fi password, like you see in the picture over here. Other ways how to obtain the password is if you have access to someone's laptop, you can use a tool like the wireless key viewer, or you just can simply look into the wireless profile in that laptop or on your mobile phone to figure out what that password is they use on that network. Now, a little bit more difficult, you can use protocol capture tools and a tool called AirCrackNG to do a password dictionary attack. That actually means you have a big list of passwords stored, and you just try out every password, and you're going to validate if that is the same password used for the encryption on that access point. And there are some other variants as well, like CloudCracker, where you can actually upload your authentication, and then on the cloud, they try to find that password. So once the password is known, there are two issues. So the first issue is a person can authenticate and associate to the Wi-Fi network and make use of the resources. And you have also a risk that he's sending or downloading the wrong type of content over your network. So that means you're accountable in the end. Encrypted frames can be decrypted, also of other devices, other stations we call it in the Wi-Fi world, as long as the beacon and the four-way handshake of the client is captured into the pickup file, and we see that in the demo. Now what you need is a Wi-Fi protocol analyzer to visualize both clients and access points, because you need to see all those different frames which go up and down. Here you see an example how you can actually see how a client is connected to an access point. So the blue color is indicating the SSID, which stands for the server set identifier, the network name, that's normally the network you're searching for. Then the purple indicators, that are actually the radios of the access point. If you have a large organization, you probably have multiple access points spread out over the enterprise, so that you can roam with your mobile client or your Wi-Fi laptop to another area to connect to that network. The orange indicators, that are the clients which are connected to that particular access point. So in this example, you see a few clients connected to APs, and some other APs don't have any clients connected to it at all. So let's look into the demo from how actually all this traffic can be decrypted. Here we use Xavier's OmniPeak, and we can actually start the capture over here. Now note that we are capturing on different channels. So here we see channel 1 and channel 6 on the top. But if you go to the auto scroll, we can see that the channels are changing here from 52 to 60. And it depends if there is traffic on the channel to see it scrolling. So we're going to change that because my access point is on one particular channel. So we're going to channel 6 and the 2.4 gigahertz. And if we select that, you see that everything is stuck to channel 6, and you see that at the bottom as well. I stop the auto scroll, and I'm going to look first into one of the beacons. So here we have an Aruba access point. So it is here the beacon frame, which is a management frame, which is sent out by the access points every so many times. We have here the SSID, WW2.4 gigahertz, and if we scroll down until we see the RSN, which stands for Robust Security Network Information, we can see that the Authentication Key Management Suite is Preset Key, PSK. The pairwise transient key used is CCNP AIS, Advanced Encryption Standard, and for the group cipher as well. So it is not backwards compatible with a temporary key integrity protocol. All right, so we go back to the capture. Notice that we're still capturing in the background. And we're going to connect with the mobile phone to the network. So we're going to see that over here. Okay, so we're going to connect to the 2.4 gigahertz. Okay, so this is the password. We connect to the network. We go back here to the protocol capture tool. So you actually see that still the frames are passing by. I stop it here again. If you go here on the left side to the WLAN, here we see a lot of networks on the different channels, but we are interested in channel 6. And here we see actually the 2.4 gigahertz SSID network. Two access points belong to this network. And you see that two clients are connected here, one to this access point, and this is my phone, which is connected to this access point. And you see that we are connected with CCNP in this case for this network connection. All right. Now we're going back to the protocols over here. And in the protocols, we see all the different traffic. And we see, for example, encrypted traffic. We're going to look into that in a minute. And we see also the EPOL keys here. If you go to the packets again, and we look here, we see also the connections, the data frames from my phone to the rest of the network via this Aruba access point, that they are encrypted. Now, if you know the password, and often you know the password because it is given in a cafeteria or in a hotel or any public Wi-Fi network for a WPA2 CCNP encrypted network, you can here go to, I need to stop the capture. You can then go to decrypt wireless LAN packets, and you can then select all packets. Let's do that. Click on the three little dots, insert, and say decrypt AP client. Here we can select the different options. So we have WPA, WPA2 passphrase. The passphrase is the password here. Okay, so let's remove this. And then the SSID is 2.4 gigahertz. Now the key will be automatically generated. So I press OK here. And if I go back to this one, you can actually see that the key has been generated. Okay, so now we have to select this particular key, the key set, press OK. We get some errors because not all the frames were encrypted. So it's only going to try to decrypt all the different frames. So we scroll here and notice that you actually don't see encrypted frames here. Okay, so if I go back to the protocols over here, well, there is still encrypted data, but that is from other networks. But you notice that a lot of the traffic is not encrypted anymore. So we should actually be able to see the DHCP request, which is the traffic where a client is asking for an IP address. And if you go to those frames over here, so here we see the DHCP request. And we want to validate if that comes from my mobile phone. And we can see here that the source, this is the MAC address of my phone, to the access point where that particular frame was sent. So that means that all the other traffic is actually not encrypted. Okay, so this traffic, what you see here, encrypted, doesn't belong between my phone and the access point. Okay, so that was the end of the demonstration, how easy it is actually to decrypt WPA2 CCNP AIS type of traffic with a preset key. In NetScout Wi-Fi Analyzer, we also can capture frames and we can decode WPA, WPA2 preset key, PSK. So we go to the decode view, which is over here. We can start the capture. So we require an adapter for that, and Proxim WD8494 or one of the equivalents. So it is capturing now all the frames, but note that we're capturing on different channels. So we have to change that. So in my case, my access point is on channel 6 on the 2.4 GHz, 20 MHz bandwidth. So we're capturing now all those frames. I'm going to connect with my phone to this particular access point. So note that I don't set up a filter. You can actually set up a filter here if you only want to see the traffic for this particular access point or one of the others, but I just turn it off for now. Okay, so we're going to connect with the phone. So we now connect to a 5 GHz radio on that same access point, but we're going to change that. So we're going to the 2.4 GHz. Is over here. So we enter the password. Okay, so we can see that here. This is the password used on the 2.4 GHz radio. You're now connecting to the access point. Okay, so we go back. We now connected successfully, and you see a lot of frames going over the network. I'm going to stop the capture. And the first thing I'm going to do is to check for the four-way handshake. And the four-way handshake is actually indicated with the EAPOL frames, which stands for Extensible Authentication Protocol over Local Area Network. So let's see if we capture those. So you actually need to understand how a Wi-Fi device actually successfully associates using WPA PSK. It will use some frames, the probe request, the probe response, two authentication frames, two association frames, and then actually the real authentication finds place with EAPOL. Let me go through this. Note that we have also the traffic of the other access points. So that's maybe it was good idea to put a filter in place. Okay, here we are. So here in white, we see the first EAPOL key, the second one, the third one, and the fourth one. Okay, and this is my mobile phone I was using, the Huawei technology indicator here. And if we continue, we see actually encrypted data. Invite. So for example here we see that my phone is actually sending some encrypted data to the access point. Now we can actually check if the access point is using WPA2. So we can click here on the beacon and we can look into the frame body. So here we see the SSID, which is in this case www 2.4 GHz. Now we're going to look into the RSN, which stands for Robust Security Network Information Element. And here under the authentication management suite, we see that we make use of a preset key. And we can go to the cipher suite and we see that we're using CCMP 128. And for the group cipher, we also use CCMP. So in this case, this access point or the radio on the access point is not backwards compatible with WPA 1, with the TCAP, with the temporary key integrity protocol option with RC4. All right, so we looked into the encrypted data here. Now here on the left side, now to be able to decode the frames, you need to go to configure. You need to have actually capture to disk to have it enabled, otherwise you cannot do the decode. So you actually have to do that in advance before you do the protocol capture. Once you enable third-party decode and enable WPA2, it gives you a warning that is going to change the way how it captures the frames, and you need to do it in full frame format, otherwise you will not see the content of the data frames. So I've done that already. Then you click on passphrases, and here you can actually configure your SSID of your network and your passphrase. So this is the one I used to connect with my phone to this access point. Now once that is done and you enable those two options, and you go back to that area where we had the four-way handshake. So I'm going a little bit faster to this. Let me see where they are. Here are the four handshake again. The four frames in the four handshake. And now if we continue. For example here, is that same frame I indicated earlier on. It was then encrypted, but now it doesn't indicate encryption anymore. And it looks like a data frame that where we can see the content. Now in Wi-Fi Analyzer, it is not so easy to see, for example, what type of frames are sent over the network. We see that they are unencrypted, but it's a little bit hard to see the content. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to export this file into a PCAP file, a protocol capture file, and then going to import it into Wireshark. So I do file save as. So you have an option here to save it into an AirMagnet file, but I'm going to save it into a PCAP file. So we call it capture phone one. Save. I'm going to open Wireshark now. Open a new file. It was the capture file. Capture phone here. Capture one. So here are all the details. So we should be able to find that four-way handshake again, which has some blue colors. Here we can see the full connection flow again. So we have the probe request to www.4GHz, the probe response, the authentication frame, another authentication frame, the association request and association response. And then in blue, you see the four-way handshake with the 1, 2, 3, 4 EPOL frames. The key messages that got it changed between the client and the access point. Now, if you continue, then we will see the decrypted frames. Well, probably we will not see the decrypted frames now because we have not enabled decryption in Wireshark. So to do that, you need to go to View and you need to have your wireless toolbar enabled. And then you go to the 802.11 preferences. And under preferences, you click on enable decryption and you go to the decryption keys, edit. And here you can actually enter your decryption key. So in this case, it's a WPA2 password, which is filled in here and is the password Ronald Secure 1. Press OK, press OK. And now you should be able to see, for example, DHCP requests. For example, like here. Here we see a DHCP request on the top and a DHCP acknowledgement. And if I click on that and I look into the details, I see actually that the source address is coming from my mobile phone. So now we can really see the content of all the frame exchanges once all those WPA2, PSK with CCMP, AIS, Advanced Encryption Standard has been enabled. So we can see all the content. It is also possible to decrypt those frames in other tools, in this case Wireshark. I already exported a file from OmniPeak in this case into PCAP format. So I'm going to open this file. Here we see all the connections to the access point. Okay, and here we see the four-way handshake. 1, 2, 3, and 4. And then if we scroll down, we will see some traffic here. The QoS data. Some other data from my mobile phone to the rest of the network, to the access point. But we cannot see the details. Now, to be able to decrypt those frames, we need to go to View. Wireless toolbar need to be enabled. Then you click on 802.11 Preferences. Enable Decryption. Decryption key edit. Here, WPA password, Ronald Secure 1. Press OK. Press OK. And now are all the frames decrypted. So if you go back to the four-way handshake over here, 1, 2, 3, and 4, and we go down, then we see, for example, here the DHCP request and the acknowledgement, and we can validate that because it actually comes from my mobile phone to the access point. Here is another tool called Tamarsoft ComView, where we can actually decrypt the WPA2 preset key with CCMP and AIS encryption, Advanced Encryption Standard. So we saved that file of the earlier capture in the Xavius OmniPeak. So we're going to open that file here in the log viewer. Go to File, Import Logs. We saved it actually into a PCAP format. So that is the standard format for Wireshark as well. So we open it here. The file is called phone connect 2. And we opened the file and we see the traffic from my phone to the rest of the network. But we see that the WPA2 traffic could not be decrypted. Now if I go up here, you can actually see that the four-way handshake was captured as well. So 1, 2, 3, 4. And we can see here on the left side all the details, but all the data is encrypted. Now we go back to that main tool here. Go to the settings, web WPA2 keys. We enter the password. All right, press OK. If you go back to that log viewer, we see that still the frames are encrypted or cannot be decrypted. So we close the log viewer here. We open the log viewer again. File, import logs, go to the Wireshark over here. Phone connect 2, PCAP, open. And now we have the same file. We go back to the top, where the four-way handshake is, over here, 1, 2, 3, 4 frames. And notice that now all the other frames are decrypted, so we can see the content. For example, when my phone is asking for an IP address, that is typically done with a DHCP, Dynamic Host Control Protocol request, which you see over here. And here my phone, with this MAC address, is actually asking for an IP address. And here we have the reply. So you can actually see the IP address here as well. And the rest of all the other frames are sent in clear text. So this also proves that with all those different tools, we can see the content from layer 3 of the network layer onwards. So the solution is actually to implement VPNs, virtual private networks, like using IPsec or any of the other virtual private networks, as long as that are a strong VPN frameworks. And then everything from layer 3 all the way up to OSI layer 7, where your normal data traffic finds place, like for example file transfers or your HTTP traffic will be encrypted in that VPN tunnel. Now, if you cannot set up a VPN tunnel, then you need to set up like HTTPS type of connections. But as you saw in the video of the cracks, it is possible to make use of an SSL stripper, where actually that protocol then can be compromised as well. So you really need to implement multiple layers of security at layer 3 preferable, so that all the other layers are encrypted as well. So now we've seen all the issues, but what to do now? If you look into the OSI reference model, layer 1 is the physical layer. That's where the radio waves and the radio frequencies reside, the 2.4 GHz and the 5 GHz used for Wi-Fi communication. And we look in layer 2, the data link layer, where the Wi-Fi protocol resides, and also the encryption and security, like WPA2, CCNP and AIS. So all those encrypted data frames are getting communicated at that data link layer. And yeah, they can be compromised now. So if you look at layer 3, the network layer, where the IP addresses reside, that's actually where we need to start to do security and encryption. So we maybe can set up a virtual private network, a VPN, if your organization or your enterprise supports VPN technology. But also home users, they can get VPN software off the internet to encrypt their traffic from their client's smartphone or laptop to the rest of the network. But note that IP addresses itself can be seen, and other management traffic as well, if you have that going over your network. So think about Apple Talk, where Apple devices are synchronizing each other, because the data frames can be seen, can be decrypted, and all those traffic can be seen in the end. So if you move up layer 4, layer 5, layer 6, and layer 7, each of the layers also have different type of security solutions in place to do encryption of the traffic. But at layer 7, that's something known to most people, is the HTTPS, which is the encryption when you go to a website. But note that still SSL stripping can be done, which was shown in the WPA2 crack tool. So SSL stripping means you can do a man-in-the-middle attack. That means the man-in-the-middle is actually terminating the HTTPS traffic and then continues the session to a bank, for example. So then still that traffic can be seen. It actually gets decrypted in the middle. So be aware of that. So a VPN is maybe the best solution, but not always feasible, because sometimes you work at a public Wi-Fi hotspot or a cafe, and they only have actually no security in place. They have only open system authentication, and then they have that captive portal where you have to enter your username and password. Now, in those type of scenarios, layer 1 and layer 2 is not secured at all. All the traffic can be seen. And it's not even encrypted. Even at captive portal, it looks like the traffic is encrypted, but it is basically only to authenticate you to the rest of the network. So be careful in public Wi-Fi environment where WPA2 PSK preset key is used with CCNP and AIS. So preferable using VPN. Globeron does Wi-Fi security training, so you can find training online at our website indicated here. You can do self-study, you can contact us if you want to know more about Wi-Fi security. We run also an instructor-led class 6, 7 and 8 November in Breda in the Netherlands, but also in other regions in Asia Pacific, Europe, Middle East and Africa, North America, Latin America. Just contact us at sales@globeron.com. So hereby we hope we give you a good overview how easy it is to actually decrypt that WPA2 CCNP AIS encrypted traffic. So thank you for your attendance.